I'm Deepak Chopra. You're watching One World with Deepak Chopra, coming to you from Deepak home base in New York City. And my very special guest today is cardiologist William Davis, MD. And he has a new book, Wheat Belly, Total Health. Wheat Belly, Total Health. So, first of all, thank you for joining me, Dr. Davis.
Well, thank you for having me.
I read your book about 6 months ago. I was traveling, the previous book, The Wheat Belly Diet. What was it called, actually, the previous book?
Wheat Belly.
Yeah, Wheat Belly. So I was traveling in Europe, and I met our common friend, Paul. And I noticed he'd lost a lot of weight, and I said, what are you doing? And he referred me to your book, Wheat Belly. And I was totally fascinated by the information. I went off wheat, and I lost, since then, about 25 pounds, too. And it was totally effortless, I have to say. I didn't change anything except eliminate wheat from my diet. So I want to get into the background of this. I think this is a very important book. Again, once again, the book is Wheat Belly, Total Health. When did it come out?
Just September 2014.
Okay, so it's brand new. And I want to know a little bit about your own background. So you're a cardiologist. How did you get interested in this particular topic?
You know, Dr. Chopra, it didn't start out that way. I started, as you did, in a very conventional setting. I was an interventional cardiologist doing angioplasty, implanting stents, all those kinds of things for heart attacks, myocardial infarctions and all that. I became very unhappy, disenchanted with this notion that heart health comes through a cath lab or a procedure. I started to redirect my efforts to wanting to identify it early, maybe stop it, prevent it, perhaps even reverse it. One of the, as you know, one of the most important things we can do is help people control blood sugar. We have a nation that's plagued by terrible levels of high blood sugar, whether it's diabetes, pre-diabetes, or even just
and
blood sugars.
And all the comorbidities.
Yes.
From blindness to amputations to heart attacks to cerebrovascular accidents, even autoimmune diseases, so inflammation in the body. So go ahead.
Well, we could do it, of course, with insulin and oral hypoglycemic drugs, but what if we want to do this with diet? Well, I reasoned this through very simply, and by the way, I had made myself diabetic about 25 years ago when I didn't know what I was doing in diet. That's when I was doing my procedures and all that sort of thing, and I went on a diet low in fat, no animal products, only lots of healthy whole grains, fruits, and vegetables. While I was jogging 3 or 5 miles a day, I became a diabetic.